I'm finally switching password managers. And if you know me, you know that's a big deal. I've been a loyal 1Password user for many years, and it's honestly been hard to leave. So what changed? Why now, after all this time, am I making the switch to Proton Pass? Let me take you through why this decision took a while, why Proton Pass is the one that finally convinced me to move on, and what are the three missing features I still want Proton Pass to fix? First, let me clarify. 1Password is still an amazing password manager. If you use it and enjoy it, more power to you. The main reason I haven't switched sooner is simple. I didn't need to. 1Password has everything I've needed. Smooth auto login, file attachments, even passkey management. But the privacy first approach, and honestly, the steady stream of improvements coming from Proton Pass finally got my attention. Proton has built a reputation for secure communication through Proton Mail, and with Proton Pass, they've created a password manager that doesn't just protect your data, it also enhances privacy in a way that I feel like 1Password just couldn't match. So let me explain. About a year and a half ago, I published a review of Proton Pass that covered the features that were available during its initial release. I mean, password managers are a dime a dozen, so what made Proton Pass different? Aside from being part of Proton's trusted brand recognition, Proton came out of the gate with open source code, something that 1Password doesn't do. Actually, a lot of other password managers don't do. They also had the standard end-to-end encryption, ensuring that only you have access to your vault, which that's the same across pretty much any password manager that you would use. But the two biggest features that set Proton Pass apart when they first launched was the fact that they offered a useful free tier of the product, and they had seamless integration of email aliases. Now, that free tier still exists and allows for unlimited logins and unlimited devices, while most of the major password manager players, like let's say 1Password, Dashlane, for example, they operate more on a freemium model, which is, it's where they have that free tier that's either limited in time or it's missing features that honestly make it useless unless you buy the subscription. If you opt for the Proton Pass free tier, it's entirely possible to use that without any paid upgrade. The features you pay for are things like unlimited email aliases, which I'll talk about in a moment, an integrated 2FA authenticator, which I would miss in the free tier, honestly, vault sharing, dark web monitoring, and a few other minor benefits. The big feature, however, was the email aliases. Back in 2022, Proton bought Simple Login, an alias forwarding service, and integrated that into the Proton Pass product so that when you create a new login, it not only gives you a strong and unique password, it also gives you a strong and unique email username that forwards to your primary email account. This offers better security in the event that any data breach happens, but it also allows for more control because you can easily disable or delete an email alias that gets exposed or misused. Now, in the years since my last review, Proton Pass has done a fantastic job of rolling out new features consistently, many of which I had asked for in that earlier review, and that really solved the obstacles that had kept me from migrating away from 1Password earlier. For example, shared vaults. For those of us who need to share passwords with family or coworkers, this feature alone is a game changer. It's absolutely necessary. They've introduced a family plan, which allows for 6 user accounts, and you can share different password vaults with each of them. And then there's this interesting feature called Secure Link that allows you to create an encrypted link that Proton can't see, and it allows you to share a specific login. You can set this link to expire after a certain period of time. You can restrict the number of times it can be viewed, and then you can even go in and disable the link at any time. You're still sharing your password with somebody else, and they could easily copy it down if they wanted to, but at least they don't have to create a Proton Pass account in order to see this shared login, and your login still remains private from Proton. So just keep all of that in mind. From a security standpoint, there are a couple of big improvements that I've been really happy to see. The first is what they call the extra password feature. For me, there's always this fear that if someone somehow gains access to my Proton account, and if you use them like I do for email, calendar, drive, and now as a password manager, that hacker would get instant access to basically my entire online life. So you've got your Proton Pass vault, and that remains separate from all the other Proton products that you use. And now that vault can be encrypted using a separate password from your primary Proton login. So now when I set up Proton Pass on a new device, I have to log into my Proton account to download the vault onto that device, but then I have to input an extra password that I've set to decrypt that vault. This was a big gripe that I recently had with Apple's new password app. The app locks with biometrics, but there's no way to create a backup code that is different than the one you use to unlock your phone. And in my opinion, that's just not a secure way to do it. With Proton Pass, I have the option to unlock using biometrics if I want, the extra password or a unique PIN that I can set. And frankly, I'd be surprised if Apple doesn't update their password app soon to offer the same option. And a quick side note, I had heard about the biometrics option, but couldn't find it in my settings. It took me a moment to realize that the web app version of Proton Pass doesn't offer biometrics, but thankfully Proton now has dedicated apps for iOS, Android, Windows, macOS, and even Linux. Before it was just a browser extension, which they still have. So this is a huge upgrade in terms of cross-platform compatibility. Okay, moving on from security, from a usability standpoint, I like that we're now able to store and autofill credit card info, making it more versatile as a secure information manager. So now we have the option to create logins, store cards, create secure notes, and fill out an identity. Now, this identity piece is helpful, especially since you can create custom text fields, but as I'll explain in just a moment, there's still something missing here. Overall, I've been drawn to the aliasing solution of Proton Pass, but I had to wait for a lot of these features because when you're using a password manager as a family or among your small business team like I do, there is significant friction to moving password managers. You gotta get everybody else to do it with you. And that's the biggest reason that it took me so long to switch. But now that I have, I'm happy about the decision, but I have to point out three things that I still miss from 1Password. The biggest feature I miss from 1Password is their auto login or auto submit, which I didn't realize I enjoyed so much, frankly. Basically, when I get on a login page and choose the correct login, 1Password not only autofills the username and password, it also clicks the login button for me. Now, sometimes this would get me in trouble if there was some kind of captcha I had to fill out, but for the most part, it would save me a click every time I needed to log into an account. Proton Pass, at least right now, doesn't offer this feature, and I'm surprised by how easily I get frustrated that I now have to move my mouse over and click to log in. First world problems, I know, but if you've gotten used to this feature as well, you'll probably miss it like I do. I also quickly noticed when I imported all of my logins from 1Password that all of my file attachments were missing in Proton Pass. As somebody who lives overseas in a different country, I find it really important to keep scanned copies of all of my major documentation available and ready for me. That's things like passports, visa pages, birth certificates, that kind of stuff. I wish that during the import process, Proton would have prompted me to, I don't know, create a folder in my Proton drive to put all of these files. Instead, they just don't import it at all, and now I have to manually create that file or that folder and then move all these files over myself. Now, I understand that Proton has Drive, which is their online encrypted file storage. But if somebody is just using Proton Pass and not the entire suite of Proton products, this feels like a pretty big missing feature. I can create this file on Drive, so it's not a big deal for me right now, but like I said, I wish that was part of the import process. Finally, my third gripe has to do with passkeys. And this really isn't Proton's fault as much as it's just a limitation of passkeys in their current form. I was not able to export my passkeys from 1Password into Proton Pass. They just aren't there. Now, this would be true in migrating to any other password manager, but it's worth considering the fact that when you migrate, you're going to need to find which accounts had passkeys, disable the old ones, and create new ones in your new password manager. Now, stop here. This is one reason why I prefer to own my passkeys by putting them on something like a YubiKey instead of lending them to my password manager. That being said, I've read reports that say the FIDO Alliance is taking steps to make passkeys more easily transferable. Is this a good thing? I mean, when you're migrating password managers, definitely, but I'm not sure transferable passkeys are a great idea from a security standpoint. But that's just my opinion. So while I still have a lot of love for 1Password, Proton Pass's features, both old and new, convinced me that it was time to make the switch. It's hard to ignore the added security layers, the email aliasing, the seamless cross-platform experience, and of course, that focus on privacy. Proton did not sponsor this video, but if this review was helpful, you can use this affiliate link to help support the channel. And by the way, if you want to learn more about using email aliases and learn about the strategy that I use for them, watch that video next.